Hello everyone, it's Vicky. I'm here today to do the long-awaited Traveler's Notebook collection. So I've been trying to go through all of my shelves kind of behind me to make sure I capture all of them and show you all of them. I know this has been something that's been requested. Many of you want to see all of the Traveler's Notebooks that I've had, and I want to use the disclaimer of A, this is not to make people feel like their collections are inadequate or that I have like a problem. I probably do have some sort of a problem, but this has been a collection for me for several years, okay? I didn't start liking Traveler's Notebooks yesterday or a week ago or a month ago. This has been years that I have been into Traveler's Notebooks. So it's been years of collecting and choosing pieces that I really and truly love. I have not sold any Traveler's Notebook that I've purchased. I've never swapped one and I've never sold any. They're all very, very close to my heart, and they're ones that I don't think I ever will part ways with because I haven't since. And I probably had Traveler's Notebooks for at least, I'd say, 4 years. I think it's coming on to 4 years now that I've had them, and I don't feel like I want to part ways with any of them. I love them all. I love to switch them out. Some of them I switch out on a weekly basis, some on a daily. I use several at a time. If you've watched my videos, you'll know this, and I absolutely cherish and love them. I will also show you my newest one that has been added to the family. I know, isn't it beautiful? It is in the color persimmon. It's absolutely stunning. I will give you an up close look and let you know where this one came from, but this has been the newest addition to the family, and it just came in actually yesterday is when it came in. It's just absolutely stunning, so I can't wait to share that with all of you. But I'm actually going to kind of have you a little bit it's gonna be a little vloggy because I can't possibly take every single thing down from the shelves to show it all to you. So I'm actually gonna take you through like a POV style where you guys feel like you're standing right next to me, and we're gonna take a look at all of them, and I'm gonna pull them off the shelves to kind of just change things up a little bit. And I'll try and share and link everything down below to let you know where they all came from. Some of these you won't be able to get a hold of because they were kind of a limited edition or they're older. Like I said, I've been collecting for a very, very long time, as you'll see in my collection. I'll try and start off with some of the very first Traveler's Notebooks that I purchased, and then I'll work my way to the more recent ones. So let's get started. All right, ladies and gentlemen, so here are some Traveler's Notebooks. Now the one on top here, this very first one, and again, I apologize, I'm going to try and do this the best that I can so you guys kind of feel like you're here with me. So this was actually a kit I purchased on Etsy to make your own and dye your own. So this person is no longer in business, but I love this because this was my first, one of my first Traveler's Notebooks, and it was a kit that you purchased from this lady. I think it was like $14. It had instructions on how to dye this and also how to do the string. And it's just, I mean, it's a little passport size. Hang on, let me see if I can open it up. It's a very kind of stiff leather, real simple, but I dyed it and I actually put all the elastics in through there and that little knot at the top. So this was one of my very, very first. I even have a video on how I believe how I put this together and dyed it. And many of you have asked about this, but the lady is no longer in business. So that's one of my firsts. And then this one, I actually bought leather off of eBay and dyed it myself, like a beautiful green, and put red elastic in there. And I had a few requests actually in the past to purchase this. You can see the beautiful green color and then a Leuchtturm. What is that, a pen loop? But it's absolutely, I love this. I love this one. And I bought eBay, on off of eBay is where I bought the leather. I bought it off of eBay. This kind of gives you a little bit of a better light. Again, I'm trying to do this kind of cool so you feel like you're here with me. But it's a beautiful like emerald green. And I just bought the leather dye. And I'll leave the leather dye down below and show you guys the one that I love to use, because it's a different one than I use for like dyeing my planners. It's a different one. So those were, so the, here it is, here's the green one. And then I'm gonna try, I think maybe just move over here and show you this one since it's right here. This is in, I believe it's called Tree Frog. And this is from Crazy Organized, and it comes with this leather, I shouldn't say leather, it's a feather, excuse me, charm on there. And it just, I love it, it's very like,
fantasy feeling to me. It's very floppy. It's a nice leather, and inside it has like a hot pink color in here with the gold. It's absolutely stunning. It's from, oops, it's from Crazy Organized is what that one's from. So I'm going to kind of zoom back just to kind of show you guys what they look like. So that guy right there is the one from Crazy Organized. And then you can see I have some Hobonichis over here, as well as this guy right here, this pink one. So this pink one here is from Chic Sparrow, and it's absolutely stunning. You guys in a different kind of shot. So this is from Chic Sparrow. This was one of her first releases of this color. It's this beautiful, beautiful pink. I can't remember what it's called now. If you guys remember it, please tell me in the description below. But it's in a, gosh, standard traveler size notebook. And I started doing my listers, got a list in here. So this was one of the first listers, got a list that I did in a traveler's notebook. I think it's, is it, gosh, I can't remember now what it's called, but it's this beautiful pink with the pockets, the pocket kind of configuration that Jennifer from Chic Sparrow does. It's absolutely beautiful. I love this. I can't remember what the name of it is. I know she's released these pink colors again since then, but this is one of the first, the very kind of original ones that she had done. Here are some of the little guys that I have. The one on top, the black one, is from Naked Cow. And this is, let me open this up, and I'm doing everything one-handed. This is the one with the wallet. And I have videos on all of these. I'll try and link all these on like actual reviews so you can see this. But it has a gorgeous magnetic kind of wallet thing to it. And I love this. This is from Joey, and it's kind of in a field notes size is what I would say. And then this is a creme, and this was called Creme Brulee before I think it was changed. I feel like it was changed, and it's just kind of in a classic. And you know it's one of the older ones because the elastic is actually coming out the back and not the side. So you know this is like one of the first ones that Jennifer had out, and I love this. Like, I absolutely love the leather on it. You can see kind of if you know, anyone from Chic Sparrow watches this, maybe they can know how many years this is. I feel like it's been several, though. I feel like I was buying from Jennifer when she was still on Etsy, because yes, she was on Etsy, and then she actually gifted this one to me with one of my orders when I ordered from Jennifer. And she had on the bottom here, bottom there, it says Miss Vicky B. And she gifted this one to me, and I love it. It's just stunning. The leather on this is just beautiful, to kind of give you an up-close look at it. It's just stunning. And here's the creme, like just a nice up-close to give you a look at the leather and just kind of the wear, and how funny it is how that like elastic was on the back. That was where the elastic originally would come from. And then this one was from Joey, the beautiful black pebbled leather. Stunning. And then this guy is also from Joey. This is one of the first notebooks that Joey had sent me from Naked Cow. And you can see the logo on the back, the Naked Cow logo, which he had to change, unfortunately, to Journals by Joey. But I love this because I've rolled it several times, and it's softened a lot. And I just love kind of that, just that rustic feel to it. It's still relatively stiff because I don't use it like on the daily, but it's absolutely beautiful. I just love, look at that color. It's just stunning. So these are my little guys. Now this guy here is called a Foxy Fix. This was when it was still called the Le Petit, which is like a personal size for a traveler's notebook. And I believe this is in Sandstorm is what it's called. It's beautiful. I have a comparison video with this and Chic Sparrow that I can have linked down below so you guys can see a little bit more up close and personal. But currently what I have housed in here are the little inserts from Planner Perfect, from Jenny from Planner Perfect. I love them. They're little personal size notebooks. This leather, I highly would recommend rolling it. It is a very stiff leather. It's a beautiful leather, but it's a very stiff leather. So I highly would recommend rolling that one. This guy right here is a Jonelli fish. Comes with beautiful charms that she makes. They're just stunning. And I wanted this so badly. I waited for this for months. It's in the passport size, or field note size, excuse me. And I just love the galaxy on this. I just love it. It's so beautiful. It has two elastics to really kind of house your inserts. The inside, it's like a beautiful, beautiful pink. And this is a trifold. So this kind of came out when it was really popular that people were doing a lot of trifolds. I even have one from Chic Sparrow that's a trifold that I'll show you guys in my collection. But this is just stunning. Okay, next up, and I will probably do an in-depth video on my like more patinaed, my veg tan traveler's notebooks. But this is from Buteo Bunker. It is in a B6 size. I just love Buteo Bunker, if you didn't know that. But it's already started to patina. You can see that, especially on the spine. This guy here is showing a lot of wear and love. You can see that, just like all the scuffs on here. And I will definitely go with this one more in depth. All the veg tan kind of ones. But again, Buteo Bunker, real nice and thin leather. I'm a huge fan. And this is in the standard size. This is one of the original Foxy Fixes. This is in the mango color with a mint elastic. This is a really like stiff, you can almost hear like when I tap on it, you can hear that versus the more dull with this leather. So you can hear the dull. And this one has got like a hard plasticky almost. I was not a huge fan of this, and I still am not a huge fan, but I keep it around just for the color. I love the mango color on this. I don't love how stiff the leather is, though, but, you know, Foxy Fix has changed kind of what they do and how they do it. But this was one of the original ones. You can see the elastic, again, comes out the back rather than off the spine, where most of them are coming out of now. I also have a bay leather, and this one is in A5, so I'm sorry, that one isn't in A5, the mango, and then this is the bay leather. I do like the bay leather a lot. It's very kind of soft. It almost feels like suede. It's like furry. It's a much nicer, like if I tap it, you can hear it's a little bit more dense, and I love this leather. I think it's beautiful. Okay, down here, this guy here, this is actually from Chic Sparrow. This is in an A5. This is an A5, and I believe this was in Gemini leather, and it is a trifold. This is when, like, Jennifer was trying to do trifolds, and I'll show you guys how beautiful this is. I love this. Like, I will never give this guy up. Look how beautiful this is, and it's got, like, the distressed edging around it, and it's huge because it's a trifold, so you can see how big it is. But it holds A5 notebooks, and I just love this TN. And like I said, I will not give this away. I will not sell it. I will not give that away because it's just too beautiful and too unique. She doesn't really have that anymore in her store. Then here I have a, this is from Glenda Slan. She's by Paper Flower Designs, I believe. And again, I'll have her link down below. She put my precious little nacho in there. This leather is absolutely stunning. Whatever the leather is that Glenda uses, it is like just absolutely beautiful. There's like little gold pockets on the inside here. And again, I have a full review on this, but they're absolutely stunning. And I love how these pockets feel. They melt with all of your like cards and things like that. They're just beautiful and stunning. Her work is absolutely amazing. I can't brag enough about Glenda's work. I just love her work. And I love that I have Nacho, my little chihuahua, on my notebook. Then I have the classic Midori. This is actually a classic Midori. I don't know if many of you know that I actually have a classic Midori, but I do. And it's okay, but I didn't ever really love the classic Midori. I just don't love the leather because there's so many other options out there. So I don't fancy it all that much. Then I have a fabric kind of Dory here, and it's got nurses on it. And I love the little nurse's hat charm that's on there as well. And I do have a video on this one as well. So that's why I'm telling you guys this, because I'm not going to go very in depth on everything, but I absolutely love this. I had to get it once I saw it. I had to get it. It has the unfinished edges on it. So it's got like more raw edges on there, but I just love it. It's super lightweight. Very fun, and I just thought like I would probably want to put some nursing tails in there, just from like patients that I've had and things like that. Then this guy here is from Cody, who does not do traveler's notebooks anymore, unfortunately. I know I've had some people ask me where he's been. I don't know what he's doing, but I know he's not making traveler's notebooks any longer, which is a shame, because this is absolutely one of my all-time favorites. It is by it is a Horween Chromexol type of leather, and it's like, it looks just like caramel. Like, that's the best way I can describe it. It bends beautifully. Let me open it up. The leather just bends like butter. I mean, it is just, it's just stunning. It's so mushy and so soft, and you can see all the nicks and dings, and just love that this has had. I love this, and I'm sad that he doesn't make these traveler's notebooks anymore, because I love them. And then I was gifted this beauty, this luxurious traveler's notebook, and it is actually furry. So when you touch it, it's actually fuzzy, which I love. And it's just like a luxe traveler's notebook. It's in an A5 size. There's beautiful pearls that are at the bottom there that are bookmarks, as well as at the top. They're just for decorative purposes. And the inside, and it has a clear elastic. And like I mentioned before, I have actual like full-on videos on all of these, but the interior is red. So red felt on the inside. It's absolutely stunning. That's my favorite combination, is like the leopard and red. I love that. Just stunning. I love it. And my friend Mandy Jean sent me from her shop this beautiful traveler's notebook. This is a smell that is so beautiful for leather. It's a gorgeous piece of leather. I love the craftsmanship and the flap, and how I love these trifolds still very much. And as you can see down there, it's the silhouette of a German Shepherd and a paw. So I've got my Hanky, and Mandy Jean actually has a dog named Hank as well. But I believe he's a bloodhound. He's a big boy, and so is Hanky. He's a big boy. My Hanky and her Hanky, they're both big boys. But the work in her notebooks is just beautiful. This smell, and like this rip, like this show you like the wrinkling on this leather, is just beautiful, and the color is stunning. I hope you guys can see that on the camera. It is a beautiful, beautiful piece of work, and I love that I've got my Hanky on there with the paw print. I just love that. It's just beautiful work. I just have some K-Hears in here that I just did some memory keeping in this notebook. So just love, and like I said, Moleskine K-Hears is what are inside there. It's just absolutely stunning and beautiful. Okay, moving on now. Right here in front is actually a navy blue traveler's notebooks, again from Cody, but like I shared, he does not do these anymore, but it's absolutely beautiful. And then one of my lovely subscribers sent me this charm. Is actually a V and a little B for Miss Vicky B. I love it. It's so pretty. I love this charm so much. And it's a beautiful, again, this is a navy blue. It's hard to show this on the light. It looks black, but it's actually navy blue with white stitching. It's in an A5 size. And it's, again, that like kind of Chromexol type of leather. And I just love this. And I'm just really sad that Cody doesn't do traveler's notebooks anymore, because I love the leather that he got a hold of. Not that there aren't gorgeous leathers out there, because hello, here is the flapjack. This is, I like to think, the like one of the originals ever made, because I got one of these from Joey a long time ago. And flapjack is probably one of my absolute favorites. I love, look how that beautiful pebbliness of this. I just love flapjack. Flapjack and cherry ice, I think, are like my top from Joey. I just love, oh gosh, and I love sea glass too. Never mind, I'm not going to say that, because I love all of his work. And this is also from Joey from the Naked Cow. Look at that pebbly beautifulness. This is the Black Beauty. I mean, this is so stunning. I just love traveler's notebooks. See, that's gorgeous pebbliness. And then this little guy I made, inspired by Courtney Diaz, Little Raven Ink. I love making that little guy there. And just some journaly stuff. So just to show you guys, I do use my traveler's notebooks, and I'm in and out of them all the time. I like to switch them out all the time. But these are beautiful, just beautiful, 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 from Joey, the Naked Cow. And these are like some of the originals that I like to think that I got from Joey back in the day. Okay, this is one of the more original Shakespeare cremes. This is, again, this elastic is coming out the back, and it's in a dark chocolate. It's very just a classic. I love this. And inside I have from Planner Perfect. I have her inserts in here from Jenny Penton. I love this leather. It's just so gorgeous. It's stunning. And behind it is cherry ice. Like I said, I love cherry ice. I mean, gosh, it's like an absolute favorite of mine. And I just love this. I think my reaction to when I first got this, I couldn't believe it. I never touched a leather like this. It's the Napa leather. Still to this day, I don't know that I've ever touched a leather like it, except for my new one that I'm going to show you guys. But this leather is just superb. It's absolutely amazing and beautiful. And I love the cherry ice so much. It's just such a soft and luxurious leather. Okay, then I've got this guy here, again, from Chic Sparrow. It is not in the Joy color, I think. Joy was yellow. Whatever the most recent green collection was that Jennifer Harvey had, it's not that. It's actually from a while back, a couple of seasons ago. It's, I believe, Gemini leather, and it's beautiful. I love it. It just, the only thing I have with it is it feels dry. You can almost like hear that. It feels dry for some reason. But I love the color. And again, inside of it, I have Planner Perfect inserts. I have inserts in here that are Planner Perfect inserts. They're just gorgeous. I love Planner Perfect inserts. They're stunning. And the color, I love, love this color. This is from Speckled Fawns. It's in an A6 size. This is in a wide size. And this is an A6 size. I love this one. It's a huggable. And it's such a mushy suede material with the beautiful like pebbliness on it. I adore these two. I love green. If you guys didn't know that, I love the color green. All shades of it. I really enjoy the color green. It just feels like such a joyous color to me. It's very refreshing and I really love green. It's just a really beautiful color. But these guys are, I love. And there's that's a pen ink. That's from when I took it on vacation. A couple summers ago, and I was sketching outside, and it's got a pen ink from me sketching outside on it. Okay, moving on, I have more green. So this is a Webster's Color Crush planner. I'm sorry, a traveler's notebook. This guy is a Sea Glass by Joey, and I had him put red thread and red elastic, and it's just, oh, I just love his traveler's notebooks. I think they're just amazing. Again, I have a full on review of this guy. Love it. The leather is just superb. This is a Sojourner. This is the very first Sojourner that I got from Rowena. And I don't know, to be honest with you, if she has this leather anymore. I could be wrong, but I thought that she didn't have this leather anymore. I got this back in March, like, last year, I think March, and it's just beautiful. I love the green elastic on it, and I'll have to ask Rowena if she still carries this guy, because I just love that guy. And then this is the Veg Tan leather from Joey from the Naked Cow, or now he's Journals by Joey. He had to change his name, and I love that leather too. And I, like I said, I'm going to do a video for you guys on all the natural leathers and just kind of how they wear, but I just love the Joey. I love his notebooks. So these are, again, and you can tell I've got a thing for green. You know, the more I look at these, I can think I really got a thing for green and red. I really like red too. Oh, hey there, Mr. Darcy. Oh yeah. So I've got Mr. Darcy, of course, in my collection. So this is the burgundy Mr. Darcy that I've had for quite some time. And then this is the more like caramel, the lighter colored one, that I haven't had for that long, and I can't wait to see how that one's going to patina. This one I love. The only thing is, I'm going to bring you guys close, and I can't tell what is on the front of this. I want to say it's probably some sort of lotion or something that I used, because it was beautiful when I first got it, but it almost has like a haze on it. If anyone knows what I could do to possibly do away with that, but you can almost see like where the shine kind of comes through, and then there's like a haze, and it was not like that originally. It just, something happened to it, and I'm assuming it was something on my hands, like some sort of lotion that I had on my hands, but it kind of caused it to have almost like a haze over it for some reason. But I love this nonetheless. I rolled it, and I think it was much better after rolling it than when you don't roll it. I just prefer it when it's rolled. And then here is the other one, and this is really relatively new. This one's an A5. This guy here is an A5, and this one is just the wide one. And in here I am housing a the Stalogy notebook. So I'm just kind of keeping that guy in here, and I love this thing. I love how it feels. I love how it smells. I love traveler's notebooks. I love Jennifer's work. I mean, I love every but one of my traveler's notebooks. Honestly, they all have a story to tell, and they all mean something to me, and I love them all. Okay, some absolute collector's items here. So I've got the Old Man Comfort from ZenCraft right here in a B6. A little more complex than just a simple bifold, because you get a little pocket right in here. So what's amazing about that is that you can actually just put like a field notes in there or any kind of smaller notebook, which I love. And you can use like your grocery list or anything like that, and just kind of pop it out and take it with you to the grocery store and instead of taking the whole thing. But I just love Old Man Comfort. He's an absolute favorite. This is Seed. This is my second Sojourner by Rowena. I love Rowena. I think she's amazing. I love looking at her periscopes, and I love how she actually she's so into her products, and she uses them and shares how she documents her life in them, and that they're inspired by that. I love that. And this is the Beautiful Mermaid. Look how gorgeous she is in all her beauty. This is from ZenCraft. Love her. Just love her. If you're able to catch one of these mermaids, I mean, just as a collector, it's amazing. It's absolutely amazing in the B6 size. I love how it feels. You would think that this is like raised, like scaly, but it's not. It's actually very soft and smooth, but it looks like it could be raised and scaly, just like scales on a mermaid's tail. I just love them, and that beautiful gem right there. Oh, she's just so pretty. Love her. She holds a lot of the beautiful stories. I just love her. She's gorgeous. Okay, these are from Arthur from Innovative Journaling. I got that little guy for free. He had a promotional, and then I ordered this guy. I believe it's in the sole is the size. It's more like an A6 size. And something that really draws me to this is the Solomon's knot that's back here. And in order to pop your notebooks in and out, you can tighten them using the Solomon's knot right here. And I love that. I think it's really innovative and unique. Not to mention, not only the Solomon's knot, but these are like, these really, really, really feel like Indiana Jones notebooks. I mean, they're amazing. I love these notebooks. They lie so flat. I love them, the pockets. And the paper in here is Arches paper. It's text woven Arches hand torn paper that's inside of here. And I love this paper. It's absolutely stunning and amazing. And just the weight to this notebook, I just adore these. This one just has a small composition notebook for notes, and then just a little one of these hand torn ones as well. I just love this Arches text woven paper. Just amazing. These are absolutely stunning. If you haven't seen Arthur's work, I will have it obviously linked down below, but it's just stunning. I love these so much. They're amazing. Okay, the one down here is from Pelidori. It's absolutely stunning. It has like a wax on top, and the wax will actually wear away and give it like a blue jean effect. It already kind of looks like blue jeans, like a stonewashed blue jeans, but it's absolutely stunning and beautiful. It's in the B6 size, and I love it. I also have one that I'm not going to show you because I'm putting it in my what's my kind of current video, and I don't have that up yet, and I'm not sure which one will go up first, but you will see that very soon. And then here is the Foxy Fix Sandstone. Now, it's a really pretty color. This leather is so different, though, than anything else. This leather is so different from anything else I've touched. Now, there is almost like rubber. It's, it's floppy, but it almost smells like a rubber sole of a shoe. And it's extremely floppy, which is great, but it doesn't, it just has a weird, it's very different. It's a very different type of leather. I don't love the smell because, like I said, it smells like a rubber shoe. It smells like moccasins that you would buy. I guess that's why it's called moccasin leather, but it smells like if you would buy moccasin shoes or house shoes and they kind of have a rubber smell. That's what this kind of reminds me of. I do wish I ordered the stitching around it. I think it would look a little more finished with the stitching if I got the stitching kind of around on the edges. So you can see kind of what the edges, it just looks very cut raw, which I think is great. I think it's cool. But this leather isn't like rugged enough. It's not Indiana Jones enough to be, in my opinion, to be that kind of rugged looking. But that's in an A5 size, and the Pelidori is in a B6 size. Okay, now my Buteo Bunker over here is in a B6 slight. The leather on that is just superb. It kind of reminds me of the creme. Feels luxurious, smells wonderful, beautiful craftsmanship with the Buteo Bunker. And then this is a personal size from Jennifer Harvey in Black Beauty, I want to say. It's what it's called. It's gorgeous and pebbly, and I love it in that personal size. Great for kind of toting around and carrying in your purse, and it's just a beautiful, beautiful leather. And now lastly is my newest family member, and this is by our atelier, Rosie. Does beautiful work. I did wait a very long time to receive her. I ordered in October and received it in just yesterday, January 19th. So it took a very long time to get to me, but she's working on her shipping. The leather on this is not like any other leather I've ever touched on a traveler's notebook. It is just insanely soft, smooth, very luxurious. It's in the color, I believe, persimmon. It's either persimmon or pumpkin. I'll clarify that down in the comments below, but I'm sorry, in the description below, but it's just beautiful. I mean, it is in a B6 slim size. It's gorgeous, you guys. It's absolutely gorgeous, the leather on there. I'm going to try and get pictures in a better lighting for all of you to see it. And I also got some monkey knots from her as well. It's just gorgeous. It's absolutely, it's stunning. The leather is beautiful on this. And that's the newest addition to the family. I hope you guys enjoyed going through all my traveler's notebooks and kind of this POV version for all of you. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you again soon. Take care. Bye.